Welcome to AGD 2021, the premier meeting for general dentistry. Facebook Live is sponsored by Henry Schein One. You're watching AGD Facebook Live, sponsored by Henry Schein One. I'm Rachel Kopchak, and you can see I am here on the exhibit floor amidst all of the action. It just opened, and people are walking through the expo floor, taking it all in. And I'm here now, joined by Doug Sliding with Henry Schein One. So, Doug, we obviously know that COVID-19 has significantly changed all of our lives forever. But what has been the biggest change you've seen that has impacted the dental landscape?
So my specialty is in marketing, and so I've watched it from a patient acquisition perspective. And basically, I think COVID has sped up something that was already happening. People were already migrating to a more online experience to try to find business, find services, especially dentistry, and COVID just sped that up. So now that more people are turning, we saw the numbers, you know, we track all the data and everything, the numbers of searches and the numbers of pay-per-click ads and different things just went skyrocketed during COVID, and it hasn't gone down either, and it's not going to.
So that would mean that all of the dental practices need to have a strong presence online. And if everybody has that, how do they separate themselves?
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing, though, is if you look at, like, a strong presence online really is the key. If someone types in dentist near me, where does a dentist come up? So every dentist has a website, but only the top five dentists come up in the top five spots, right? And in the most important searches, the most searched keywords, those dentists that come up consistently at the top get all the business. So it's not just being online, it's figuring out how to move your practice to those top spots so that you're taking advantage of this new increase in search and all the search going on.
Tell us a little bit more about what's really changed for patients. Let's say for the ones who are maybe looking for a new practice, mm-hmm. or those who actually haven't been to their dental practice in over a year.
Well, we've seen with the changes in numbers and COVID and more states opening up and so forth, we've seen a lot more people now searching again. We're seeing a lot more people looking for dentists. Most dentists, their problem actually right now isn't people looking for them, it's actually hiring people to work and keep their practice staffed properly. So the big thing right now is just to, again, make sure you're ranked in a place where people, when they do those searches, they're going to find you, and you're going to have that opportunity to bring those patients in, because they are making those searches for sure right now.
And then tell us, how can a dental practice sort of take a look at what their strengths are, what they're doing well, and then maybe what could be improved upon?
So one of the things that we've built is a online assessment tool. The reason it's, I know every company has an online assessment tool, but the difference with this one is it's actually just pulling public data from Google. And it pulls the top searches in your area, compares you to your competitors, and it does it in several different areas. It's going to look at where you rank online in terms of just overall for top keywords. It's going to look at where you rank compared to your competitors for reviews, which are critical. I mean, you can't, nobody's going to pick a practice if it doesn't have good reviews or a lot of reviews anymore. So it's going to compare you there. It's going to look at estimated cost per click in your area, which is a good indication of how busy and how sophisticated your area is in terms of search. And then it gives you scores in those areas, shows you your competitors, and then helps you understand where your strengths and weaknesses are in those areas. So
everybody should take the assessment and figure out sort of a landing point of where they're at. But from your perspective, what would you say would be the number one thing a dental practice could do right now to improve their searchability?
Get a review generation service going. You know, you should be asking for reviews with everybody that comes in, everybody that's happy that comes in, and driving that up as fast as possible. It's so critical nowadays. It helps determine where you rank and where you come up. It obviously helps determine whether people trust you and are going to choose you. And it's quick to do. If you get a good review generation service, you can, month one, start generating a lot of reviews and building that up to really help your practice.
If
five stars only, or 10 stars, depending on the platform, right?
Well, you can actually get 4-star reviews. You can get bad reviews here and there, as long as the vast majority of yours are 5 stars, yes.
And then please tell everybody where they can take the assessment that you offer to get that baseline.
So you go to hs-1.ascentpgs.com. So that's hs-1.ascent, P as in Paul, G as in George, S as in Sam.com.
And I believe you can also see that on your screen below if you are watching, and make sure to check that out, because that's going to be a really helpful tool for all practices to just get a really good idea of what they're doing well and where they can improve, especially in today's time when we've all had a lot of time to, we've had things to change, we've had things to adjust about practices, but any other pieces of advice you have?
Yeah, I just think, think of your practice in three ways. Are you easy to find online? Do you have great reviews? And are you set up to create a great message, tell a good story on your website and so forth? So just kind of think in those three buckets and you'll do well.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Doug, for your time. We appreciate it. I'm Rachel Kopchak, and this is AGD Live, of course, sponsored by Henry Schein One. We'll be back a little bit later with more live content for you.